Previously on Guerrilla Romance, Episode 1, we learned that the residents of towns are experts at navigating this enigmatic town. And we were introduced to 6 archetypal Tausenios. The jaded server, the physical healer, the party-friendly outdoorsman, the forlorn lover, the alpha dog, and the wide-eyed newcomer. We walked away from episode 1 knowing that Elena received a crash course in all things Taos her first night in town, and that Ro and Gina will take her under their wings. Adam is a crystal whisperer and river guide. Scott can't seem to get over his failed relationship with Gina, and Rich has just the scheme to help Scott win her back. Sleep with the new girl, of course. We pick up with episode 2 at the end of that fateful first night when Adam and Rich played Iceman and Goose to Scott's Maverick. Do any of them have the game or enough of a foot in reality to pull it off? Let's find out. Ladies and gentlemen, Guerrilla Romance, episode 2, Elena FM.
We have a good band playing. You can make a lot of money waiting tables for a place like this.
You just have to be willing to put up with a whole bunch of drunk people acting like they own the place. Oh, you want a job?
From the amount of that exact clientele, no thanks. I'll find something.
And speaking of drunks, what was up with the guys tonight?
Oh, I would like to say that they were in rare form, but I think that's the only form they take.
Right.
Yeah, Scott and Rich kept calling me Elena FM. What did they mean?
Who knows? When guys have been drinking, they're like little sweaty toddlers that haven't been weaned from breastfeeding, you know?
Well, whatever it was, I was really weirded out. Gina, this place is kind of gross.
Oh, what do you mean? Taos or just this bar?
So far, just the bar.
And speaking of morons on the prowl, Gina, did you see any talent tonight?
I saw one guy I wouldn't mind getting to know over dinner.
Right, dinner.
Which one was he?
He was the really tall, hunky one. Oh, his muscles were popping out of his shirt all night long. He asked for my number.
Ooh, I definitely saw him. What does he do?
I think he's a rock climber or something.
You mean Neanderthal?
No, I mean the complete opposite of Scott.
Oh. Well, he was definitely easy on the eyes.
Hopefully not on the box spring.
Hey, I want to have a housewarming party next weekend. Will you guys both come?
Yes, let's do a potluck. I can make a dairy-free zucchini lasagna.
Oh, I love it. And gluten-free, too. Hey, Elena, have you ever had a cabbage juice cleanse to detoxify your pineal gland?
Dudes, the wingman thing was not working tonight.
Yeah, right? Rich, I mean, I think you are talking to every guy in the pool room.
Shut up, man. I was working the room. It's just that everybody I talked to just wasn't that into you.
Yeah, because they, like me, are not gay.
Hey, did anyone make any inroads with fresh meat?
Hey, Elena FM!
Oh, jeez.
Sounds like a no. Can we stop calling her fresh meat, then?
What, do you got a crush on the new girl?
Well, I think that I finally remember her name. And that's a start.
You know, well, good luck with that thing. Because I bet Gina is talking to her right now, just like we were talking to Scott before.
Hey, you gotta go out there, find some guys, and don't sleep with the first one. Taste the rainbow.
I still don't know what this rainbow thing is. You know, what rainbow?
Well, you see, the plethora of guys that she's likely to bang are like the bands of the rainbow.
Yeah, whatever, and whatever. You know, I'm just not down with that whole phrase. I mean, and I doubt Elena wants Skittles either. You know, I just don't like this whole whoring around with another woman to make Gina sleep with me thing. If sleeping with somebody else besides Gina is not the answer. Methinks.
We're just a little off, guys. Top Gun, fellas! Woo!
Oh.
Woo!
Well, you fizzled like goose. Scott is obviously no maverick. And I think the whiskey is telling me I don't want to be Val Kilmer anymore.
Hey, World Cup tomorrow?
I'm on the river, bros.
Same time?
Yes. Crack of 11!
First one's on me.
Dude, the sun is so bright.
Vitamin D kills a hangover. Hey! What's going on? Hey, Gary!
See ya, fellas. Hey, Rich, you coming tonight?
Yeah, coming at potluck, 6 o'clock.
Right on, man.
Yeah.
When did the Tao's handshake become so awkward?
I know it's become a greeting of shame. A hybrid of hugs, handshakes, and homoerotic dry heaving.
So, are you going to that thing tonight?
Fuck no. I am so tired of being responsible for making things for potlucks. People don't host their own parties anymore. I mean, you know, and then if you don't go and participate, you're some sort of pariah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you could always order some sliders from the gorge and take that.
Dude, you can't take takeout to a potluck.
Sure you can. I went to a party once and somebody brought a fatty from Eskies. People were treating that like it was a dip or something. It went over pretty well. Oh, and then I went to this other party? Yeah, you know, Rita was there. The one from the gallery who you've been stalking? You know.
Oh, Rita. Those low-cut blouses. Those legs. Those dresses. And I am not stalking the watercolor gallery of schlock. But Rita?
Yeah, that makes it okay.
Shut up.
Look, Rich, you're lusting after a buxom blonde in her 20s.
Hey, what are you saying? I can't bring the game?
I mean, you can't even talk to her. I mean, if you could, I mean, you listen to the Glenn Miller Orchestra. I mean, can you even download that on an iPod?
We both know that big band swing music was the apex of the 20th century American culture. And a century, mind you, that was far more sophisticated than our current age.
Yeah. You should lead with that the next time you want to try to introduce yourself.
I will. And she'll dig it. Because I'm sophisticated and cultured.
Yeah. You're a big bear of a man who enjoys the finer things in life, like fraying chacos and a beer-stained t-shirt.
Low blow, man. You know it's not laundry month.
Look, all I'm saying is that you need to get in there and talk to her. I mean, I saw Adam ogling her the other month.
Adam? Really? crystal bullshit?
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's a river guide, and he knows constellations, and he has a dog, and, you know, he writes poetry. He's very sensitive. Oh, and I heard he knows how to work the clutch, if you know what I mean.
Where did you hear that?
Oh, I was the main headline on Live Taos last week.
Dude, he wrote that article.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, the thousands of women out there who read that stuff, they don't know.
I could work the clutch.
Look, Rich, no girl wants to date a guy the same age or younger in this town. I mean, it's a known fact that the maturation rate for adult males plummets upon moving to Taos for like 5 years.
I read that article on Facebook.
Yeah, but I think Rita... But I think Rita would still sleep with him.
Sleep? With Adam?
Crystals, man.
Crystals?
Yeah, you know, women are kind of moderately okay with some of that stuff.
Maybe I'll meet somebody at Gary's potluck.
Yeah, fat chance. Hey, what are you going to bring to that thing?
I don't even want to go. It's a vegan potluck.
Oh, God. Ooh. What are you going to eat there?
The menu consists of grass and greeting card casserole, charred masa stuffed with oxygen, and for dessert, a delightful concoction of plastic lawn chairs and starvation.
Sounds fibrous.
Wanna come?
No. You know, I think I'll be somewhere eating food tonight.
Lucky.
Hey, you know, I gotta go, man.
Wait, Rita's not out yet.
No, you'll be fine, really. I mean, I gotta take a load to the dump.
Dude, there's like a bathroom 50 yards from here.
No, I mean, I really have to take the trash to the landfill.
Dude, how is that even possible? You live in a 10x10 studio.
Yeah, I know. You know, I've been working on the land again.
What are you doing out there?
Oh, you know, nothing special. Hey, I gotta go.
But dude, what about Rita? Stay.
Rich, you'll be fine. Remember, Glenn Miller Orchestra.
Fuck you, Scott. Hi, Rich. I'm a man. You're a woman, I presume. Have you heard of vinyl records? Want to come back to my place and see my phonograph?
Went to the DMV? I have got to hear this story.
Gina, it was awful. I mean, are they out to get people or something?
You know, I'm pretty sure they will only hire someone unless they can prove they have been a complete bitch in at least 3 previous jobs.
Yeah, well, it would make sense. I was told to go early to avoid the crowds, but I got there at 7:30 and there were already 10 people there.
Sounds familiar.
And I thought I had all the required paperwork, a lease, an electric bill, a government-issued ID.
I'm pretty sure they usually want a blood sample, an autographed or letter of recommendation from the mayor, and something akin to your firstborn.
Yeah, I was totally prepared, and they still shat all over my requests. They told me I had to take a picture of my landlord, get it notarized,
ha!
And then find Rick Romancito and get him to autograph a copy of the Tempo.
Yeah. Do you know that one time they asked one of my friends to bring a hair follicle from one of Ernie Blake's kids up in the ski valley? You know, they must be witches or something.
Yeah.
Bad juju in there.
It was a mess. Hey, some guy told me about hot springs at the gorge. Can we see them from here? I'd really love to check them out.
Oh, no, no, no. Those are, they're tucked away. But be careful if you go. Don't go with a guy. Bring a friend. But I will never go there again.
Why? What's the danger?
Balls, Elena.
Balls.
Hippie balls.
Ew. Oh, my God. No, thanks. What about Ojo Calmente?
Ojo Caliente is awesome. Free on your birthday. Definitely go there.
Sweet. My birthday's coming up.
Oh, yeah? When's your birthday?
September 29th.
Oh, a Libra. Yeah, I can see that about you. You are definitely balanced. Oh, do yourself a favor. If you're interested in any guy, find out his sign before you go on a date with him. It saves a lot of wasted time. Oh, I've been meaning to ask you. Has Ro given you any light reading material yet?
Actually, yes. I came home yesterday and found a copy of Pablo Neruda's love poem on my front doorstep with a note that said, "You need this." Right. She's a trip. Oh, and she wants you to give me her copy of The Four Agreements.
Yeah, I bet she does.
Oh my God, Elena and Gina, what's up?
Hey, Adam, how's it going?
Oh, it's a beautiful day for a hike.
You aren't still hungover from Saturday night, are you, Iceman?
Of course not, Gina. The river detoxifies the liver.
Easy. Easy, Robert Frost. I'm pretty sure that your PBR hair of the dog at the put-in is not about detoxing.
Hey, Adam, can I ask you something about Saturday?
Sure thing.
Why were Scott and Rich calling me Elena FM?
You see, there's a radio station, and it's called Luna FM, and they were trying out a mnemonic device to remember your name. I mean, give you a nickname.
Sure. Sure they were.
Well, I hope it's a term of endearment. Is Luna a good station?
Yeah, if you like Sting.
Or Lilith Fair B-sides.
Doesn't sound like a great nickname.
Well, I don't think it's going to stick. But hey, how about this view, huh? You can see the whole canyon from here.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, I guess I thought the Grand Canyon was going to be mightier, but from here it looks like a creek.
Yeah, but the Rio Grande is all we've got. I like to come up here, and I love this spot. I love to come up here and channel the water cycle. The clouds speak to me. The river is my muse. The blue sky. Everything is water, Elena. We are all water, and to water we shall return. It's like a cycle.
I love it up here because it humbles me. It's so daunting. It's like you could be swallowed up and forgotten. I feel like a neglectful partner in a relationship if I don't come here often enough to pay homage. This is my church, and humility is how I stay grounded.
Oh, speaking of grounded, I've been carrying around that rock of crystal you gave me when I first got here.
Oh, killer, what do you think?
It's really grounding. I guess. I think I don't really know what that means yet.
In the spring, when the winds come, you'll know the need to feel grounded.
I love the weather now. It's been so rainy and green. Is it always like this?
No. You must have brought the rains with you. You're good luck. Maybe the mountain is finally accepting you.
Awesome. Should I call Ro and give her the good news?
No. Don't piss off the mojo. The mountain is a fickle mystic. You'll be dropped like a bad habit, but it will only be a test or something. It takes real courage to stick it out here.
Yeah? How have you managed?
By channeling the water cycle, Gina. Water is our most courageous element.
You know, Adam, sometimes you are brilliant. Are you feeling all right? Have you not been drinking your prescriptive amount of tequila?
Of course I have. Oh, actually, I've got some right here. Anyone thirsty?
No, I gotta work later. All right, fine. We really should get going, though.
Okay. Oh, but Adam, I'm gonna have a potluck next week. Can you make it?
Oh, definitely. Oh, I might have to leave a little bit on the earlier side. There's this sweet reggae show that night. Sea Lion Star Rhythms of Ja Zion Ocean. Do you know them? I'll burn you a CD. Super heady jams.
Well, maybe we should all go together afterwards.
Well, my mother always told me that my hair was frisé.
Well, it looks okay tonight. And as I was saying, you want to make sure that you wash the greens and cut them up into edible chunks before throwing them in the bowl.
I see. So in recapping, to make a salad, am I pronouncing that correctly?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So in order to assemble this salad, the chef is just picking random vegetables, washing them, chopping them accordingly, and then throwing them all together in a bowl. Incredible.
You know, as I was saying, Adam, you really have your pick of the garden when assembling your salad. If you like a crunchy salad, just add some cabbage, some roughly chopped carrots, and a stalk of celery.
Sounds healthy. Now, is this something I'd want to eat?
Well, it's not a ribeye. But I really think this might catch on.
Now, what are some of the benefits of eating like this?
Well, Adam, vegetables contain essential minerals that the body needs, and you would be surprised at how a small salad can fuel you like a regular meal would.
Now, I don't see a fryer on the table. Are French fries not a part of this preparation?
Nothing in this meal needs to be fried.
What a fun meal! We're experiencing technical difficulties.
Bear with us, folks. Bear with us. And we're back.
Where were we? Oh, right. What a fun meal. Now, do we just eat this as is? Oh, and I don't see any ranch dressing anywhere. Should I call the producers?
This meal is not in need of ranch dressing.
Well, I just can't see where the flavor's gonna come from.
Well, Adam, we have this amazing salad dressing right here. Called Damn Delicious. Here, I'll make you a plate.
Well, all right. Well, let's see here. Oh, God. It's like angels are dancing in my mouth.
Take a breath. Take a breath. So, this dressing will soon be available at local retailers. However, for the time being, if you would like to visit damndelicious.com, you can purchase one bottle of your very own, or two or three or four.
I'm having a foodgasm right now in my mouth.
So, folks, we use all non-GMO ingredients, and it's perfect on salads. You can use it on sandwiches, tofu. It even works as a pesto. Yes.
It is perfumed with the scent of Aphrodite.
This sesame nut dressing is made with organic olive oil, basil, thyme, fennel, almonds, peppers, and it has a cranberry water base. It's like a meal in itself, is it not, Adam?
I think I'm going to have to call my sponsor.
Damn delicious salad dressing, made right here, folks, in Taos, New Mexico, by our very own Mandy Stapleford. Please stand up, Mandy Stapleford!
Damn delicious. The perfect addition to your next potluck.
Hey, you know what's odd? You know, when people are born with six fingers, like that evil guy in Princess Bride, I mean, what happens when somebody asks him to give me five? He can't very well give them five. It's just weird. It's odd. I mean, it's even, but it's odd, you know?
Right, yeah. Right. Gosh, you know, I never thought of that, but it is kind of odd. And you know, creepy, but, yeah. But odd.
Mm. Very odd. You know what else is odd? When people can reach their tongue up all the way to touch their nose.
Mm.
I mean, gosh, you have to have a really long tongue and like a really long nose to be able to do that, right? Like, have you guys ever tried that?
You know, people who can do that shit are really odd.
Right.
You know what? It's kind of mildly erotic, too.
Right?
Right? Yes. Hey, I just thought of something that's really odd. And it's actually over the top weird, but odd. I have a stupid human trick.
Really? What is
it? Yes, yes. I can move my eyebrow and inflate my nostrils and wiggle my ears and flick my bottom lip all at the same time.
No, 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 no. Wait.
Yes? Yes.
No. Eyebrow, nostril, no. Ears, and lip all at the
yes,
same time.
Yes, yes, yes.
All right. I got to see this.
Okay, okay. You call it and I'll do it.
Okay. Ready?
Yes.
Here we go. Eyebrow, nostril, ear, lip. Oh, my God!
Oh. Ro!
That is totally freaky. Please do not do that in public.
Yeah.
No?
No, I'm pretty sure that no one after seeing that would ever ask you out again.
Really?
Yeah. No.
Honey.
Just don't do it.
Oh. Oh. That weird, huh? That odd?
Oh, you know what? I just thought of something that is totally odd, hysterical, and fantastic.
Yeah?
Teatro Serpiente is doing a production of The Odd Couple.
Whoa! Wow.
Right? It's going to be at the Playhouse on Gustorf Road. It will be in a couple weeks. So October 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 16th, 17th, 18th, and 19th. And for more information, you can visit teatroserpiente.com. So, ladies, these guys are hysterical, and we have got to go see that show.
Definitely. Yes.
But please don't do that stupid human trick there.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Hey, Ro. Hey, thanks for letting me come over.
You know, sure thing, Scott, but you know what? I don't have a lot of time. I have a Reiki, deep tissue, past lives, exploration client coming over very soon.
Well, what's that smell?
I am smudging away the trickster energy in my kitchen.
Wow. It kind of smells like a reggae concert. Hey, how much do you charge for a massage?
Oh, you can't afford me. Sorry.
I'd shower.
Ugh. What? What, Scott? What do you want?
It's Gina. How is she?
Seriously? You guys broke up, what, 4 or 5 times already? What is it that you want?
For her to be sad, moping, picking petals off flowers and repeating, he loves me, he loves me not.
Scott, you broke up with her this time.
Yeah, but this is the first time I initiated it.
Exactly.
Exactly what?
Exactly. If she broke up with you all those other times before, but still found you interesting enough to come back and try to make it work, well, this time it's so different for her.
Yeah. You know, she was way too clingy.
Ugh. Gina wants love, Scott.
Oh, believe me. We made love.
Ugh.
Lots of it.
While I know that's a half-truth at best. She was not looking for that. That's not what she was looking for.
She didn't want to sex?
That's not the totality of love, Scott. I mean, it works when we're younger, but there needs to be more now. You know, physical expression without physical expression is superficial if there is no depth.
Oh, there was depth, bro. There was depth.
Scott! Gross and false! Ugh. Gina wants someone to be cute with and someone to grow old with, someone to believe in and take care of her. She wants it all, Scott. Love.
I'll change.
Not if that outfit is any indication.
What? It isn't even laundry month.
Check your calendar, Scott.
Hey, bro, are you serious? Does she really want all of that?
If you believed in love, you would too.
Well, I guess I just, you know, tried so hard to make love. I never really thought about the bigger picture. How I have to foster it.
Yes! You have been brainwashed to think that love is about falling in love or some pop culture misrepresentation of how every moment drips with innuendos and sexual tension.
Well,
you know, love is something you have to build with your partner.
Yes!
Yes, you understand.
Yes! I am exactly on the same page as you.
You look crazy, Scott. What's going on in your mind?
You explained exactly to a T how I'm going to win Gina's heart back.
I'm afraid to ask.
Ro, I'm going to build Gina a house.
What? What?
Yeah, you know, a house to show her that I can build something. You know, build love, right?
Oh, Scott, I don't know. That sounds a bit drastic and too much. Does she know?
No! I mean, you gotta keep it a secret. The guys don't even know yet.
But doesn't she hate that land?
No, I mean, I bought it 5 years ago when we first started dating. After we would make love for hours. Hours, Ro. And we'd talk about moving out there and building a house with a bed under a giant bay window. It was some super romantic shit, Ro.
But Scott, I don't think she wants to live on the mesa. I mean, that's not her dream. She doesn't love to be a hovel.
No, she'll love it when she sees it.
I don't know, Scott. Be careful. Build it for you.
No, believe me, Ro, she'll love it.
Oh, Scott, I don't know. You know, I'm just so tired of you guys hurting each other and yourselves. But Scott, look, I have a client coming over soon, so you have to leave, and I have to keep smudging.
Oh, yeah, hey, make it smell real lovely. I gotta take my truck to the dump anyway.
Oh, you know, I did see that as you were driving in. What's up with all that garbage? Did a tornado roll through your sardine can studio?
No. You know, I've been working on the land lately, and there was a squatter out there, and he made a shanty. But you know what? It's kind of cool. I'm thinking about keeping the outhouse.
Gina will be so thrilled.
I know.
You know, take care, Scott. We'll talk again. And hey, are you going to Elena's house tomorrow night for the housewarming?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Great, great. And this time, no wingmen, please.
Noted.
What is it exactly?
I'm sensing some really dark energy in this one.
Yeah, I painted it after a really bad breakup.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was trying to capture the male reproductive organs' proprietary right over the domestic sector. And, you know, even though a woman can be successful in the task of creating calm inside the home, it's just, there's so much pressure to do so, you know.
Fucking huge!
You know, it can be a very violent organ.
Is it to scale?
No, of course not. And it's just a metaphor. You know, I really thought it was just gonna blend in. You know, you kind of have to train your eye to see it.
Whew. Oh yeah, I see that.
That is one huge fucking metaphor.
You know, I really didn't want it to take over the conversation tonight. Should I just take it down? I mean, I just wanted it to fill the wall space. It just still feels so empty in here.
No, leave it up. Own it. You are a passionate artist.
Whew. I'll say.
I don't know. I really just don't want this to, like, be a thing, you know? Do you think the guys are gonna...
Be mature enough to handle it? Absolutely not. Ugh, especially if they ever figure out what it is. But I don't think they have the sophisticated eye to actually be able to discern what it is.
Ugh. I think I need to get some local art. Any good galleries? Or cute artists?
You know, there are a ton of talented artists in this town. Cute, eligible ones without a shit ton of baggage? None.
No.
Well, I did meet a really nice artist outside of his gallery the other day.
Really? Who?
I don't remember his name, but it was by World Cup?
No. No, 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 no!
He seemed like a really nice guy, and he was outside painting. I really like the one of the guy, like, walking away into the horizon.
Sweetie, I'm really going to try not to interfere with too much of your decision-making here in Taos, but...
Just a firm no on that one.
Okay, I trust you.
Who wants to party?
You do.
Hey, guys. You can put your food on the table. Can I get you something to drink?
Yes! Oh. Yes, this liquor song here is called Old Pirates.
Produce Excalibur.
Redemption song.
Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun.
Okay. Easy,
dun,
fellas.
Dun, dun, dun.
Guys, we do not need you passing out on the couch next to each other again, okay?
That was once, and it was chilly out.
And we were conserving body heat.
Are you kidding me, guys?
Great to see you, Ro. Ugh.
You brought chicken wings and a burrito to our potluck?
Okay, I've been holding on to this for weeks, but I'm gonna out myself. I hate potlucks. They are the worst thing. And if somebody invites you to your house and that they don't specify, you know you're going to a fucking potluck. And somebody better bring a goddamn green salad. Hey, let's all build community through dinner and drum circles. We have community. The togetherness is killing me. Look, if I become the black sheep of potlucks in this town, as long as I live here, I don't care. And if you do invite me to a potluck, realize I'm going to bring something that my palate appreciates. And my palate was politely requesting hot wings. I have no responsibility feeding you people. If you don't want hot wings at your next potluck, do not invite Rich Grey Wolf.
Adam, and what is your excuse? A burrito from Toribio's?
I thought we could cut it into little rounds and serve it as finger food.
Class act, gentlemen. Class act.
And what is on the menu, fair lady?
I made dairy-free zucchini lasagna, roasted beets with arugula, and Elena is making calabacitas.
Boring!
Shots!
I'll have one.
I'll stick to my red wine.
Make it four.
So, where's Scott, guys?
Oh, I have a guess. I bet he is toying with his fantasy football lineup. He's obsessed. Oh, thanks, babe. He's obsessed with that god-awful waste of time. I hated that about him.
Oh, you know, he quit that. Yeah, I mean, like, he didn't have to stop, but he, like, stopped cold turkey. I mean, he said he's not even going to watch anything this season. I don't think he's watched one NFL game so far.
Really?
Bottoms up.
Who wants to eat?
Oh, can we go outside first and see the sunset? That's my version of grace.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, it was really beautiful. Beautiful driving in.
What the fuck is that...
It's a painting. It's kind of dark.
You don't see that?
I don't much care for it, if that's what you mean.
There's something troubling along the top of it.
I don't see it. Holy shit!
That's a schlong, dude.
You can't miss it!
Did Ro give that to her as a housewarming gift?
Oh, dude, that totally looks like a Ro gift.
Who painted it? Watch your head, man, it might bite.
Dude, Elena painted it. I think FM painted it.
We are not calling her that anymore. And holy shit!
Why would she hang it in her kitchen?
We are not mentioning this.
God, I feel like since I moved here, every single day ends with a beautiful sunset. Today's is especially beautiful.
Yeah, it really pops out at you.
Yeah.
Keep it together, man.
Hey, let's eat.
Hey, I thought Scott would be here by now.
I'm sure he's fine. I bet he's playing World of Warcraft on the internet. He's hanging out in his cyber fantasy world.
No. He told me last week that he deleted his account and he sold all of his warlord assets. He just doesn't want to play anymore. It's really going to hinder our virtual friendship.
Well, have you guys even been hanging?
It seems like he's giving up his hobbies. Is he okay?
Yeah, I am sure he's fine. I mean, Scott's weird like that. He is probably spending all of his time on his Wii becoming a world-class cyber ping pong player against Korean teenagers.
No. I actually heard him on Trash and Treasures the other day. He was selling his Wii.
What a renaissance man. Selling his possessions. Maybe he found God.
Oh, please. He always says he's a Buddhist, but I really think that the only thing he enjoys about that is being fat and happy. Listen, are we going to this reggae show tonight or what?
He was saying something the other day about meditating. He was, like, we were at the bar, and he was talking about something about, like harnessing his mind and quieting his ego. He seemed really intent on it.
Are we even talking about the same guy anymore?
I don't think I've ever met this man before.
But have you guys even been hanging out with him lately?
Yeah, we just talked recently at the World Cup, drinking some coffee and saying how much we love potlucks.
Very funny.
Well, last time I saw him was when we left the bar last weekend.
What was he talking about?
Well, you know, I actually did see him yesterday, and he seemed a bit frazzled, but he seemed like the same guy. I mean...
And what did you guys talk about?
Well, he was rambling about the dump.
You know what? That's exactly what we talked about.
Not potlucks.
Guys, who cares? Let's eat. We're going to go see that reggae show. What's its name again?
Sea Lion Star Rhythms of Jazzy and Ocean.
It sounds like the house band from Fraggle Rock.
Right, great.
Come on,
we're
going to
be late for the Fraggle Rock show. Who wants another shot?
Oh, me.
I'm in.
Nice. That makes like four of us.
But I think Scott wants another shot too.